Now another very common option will be I work to my feet and my opponent's leg circles around in a lasso. Now for him to have a successful lasso, he wants my hand to be deeper. If he has my hand very shallow, I'll just twist my hand and break. But realistically, they're going to get it in deep to control my hand. It's very difficult to pull this out if I try to pass, sweep me, or take me off balance. So I get to my feet. Now from this position, the tool that I'm going to use is my knee. And the way I'm going to get my knee into position is by dropping and stepping across. Now my knee will be on top of his ankle. If I allow his foot to stay behind me, I'm going to have a lot of difficulty. So to bring his foot to the forefront, I come into my squat. So I keep your foot back. I squat. My elbows move inwards. Tuck my elbows in. Now I'm going to step around and bring my knee to the inside of my elbow. There. My hand will move from his knee to the opposite pants. Pressure to break through. Step around and pull them in for your arms. I'll explain that again, guys. My opponent lassoes and locks me up. If his foot is in front of me, I'm ready to move. But if it's behind me, I'm going to pop my hips out and bring his ankle to the inside. Now I'm going to lift and place my knee on the top of his shin. Switch my grips and punch down as I pull up. This will break my grip. Come around, get a grip of their collar, and drag their leg back. And you'll get your pass. Knee on top, chain grips, break and move.